Listening Library presents Students Across the Seven Seas, SAS, Getting the Boot, by Peggy G. Strauss. Read for you by Jennifer Van Dyke.
Application. Students Across the Seven Seas Study Abroad Program. Name: Kelly Brandt. Age: 17. High school: Westlake High School. Hometown: Chicago, Illinois. Preferred study abroad destination: Rome, Italy. Number 1. Why are you interested in traveling abroad next year? Answer: I am very interested in studying the language of romance. Crossed out: romance languages. And expect that visiting Italy will give me a greater appreciation for the diversity of our world. Truth. Are you kidding? Three words: men, leather, and fashion. Who wouldn't want to travel to a place that has the most fabulous of all three? Number 2. How will studying abroad further develop your talents and interests? Answer: I will apply what I've learned from Italian couture, crossed out, culture, to my long-term career goal of becoming a fashion designer. Truth. My wardrobe will get an all-designer makeover. I'll be a fashion goddess, hopefully one who's worshipped by legions of admiring Roman males. Number 3. Describe your extracurricular activities. Answer: President of the Student Council, Dance Squad Captain, Drama Club President, Homecoming Court 3 years running, Tennis, Pilates. Truth. Scoping out boys, plundering the discount racks for designer clothes, doing my friend's makeup, and begging my parents daily to let me go to Italy. Number 4. Is there anything else you feel we should know about you? Answer: I'm the kind of person who gets along with everybody. My outgoing personality will be a great asset to the SASS program, and I look forward to sharing my enthusiasm for Italy with my fellow students. Also, I can guarantee that I'll be a student you will never forget. Truth. If you don't let me into this program when I am a famous designer, I will make sure that you never get a discount on any of my very exclusive, very glamorous signature lines. Chapter 1. Turbulence jolted Kelly Brandt out of a deep sleep as the captain announced their initial descent into Rome's Fiumicino Airport. Almost there. She looked at the view out the airplane window, expecting a fairy tale scene below her. Instead, the neat squares of fields looked surprisingly like the Illinois farmland they had passed over on their takeoff from O'Hare. Kelly could almost feel the Italian sunshine hitting her face. Rome was going to be awesome. Delicious food, tons of culture, and shopping, shopping, shopping. She pictured handsome gondoliers rowing down moonlit canals past chic Romans wearing cutting-edge European fashions. And there was absolutely no such thing as a bad slice of pizza. Who could live there and not end up worldly, sophisticated, and glamorous? She would return home in 3 months' time, a vision in flame red lipstick and couture clothes, throwing around endearments like cara and bella without sounding like a pretentious ass. Kelly yawned loudly and stretched her arms over her head, wondering just how long she had slept. Judging from the thick novel in her friend Sheila's lap, now halfway read, it had been quite a while. Kelly had sorely needed the rest. The night before, her best friends, Star and Tiffany, had thrown her a going-away party. Star Santoro was legendary for throwing the best parties. She always attracted the hottest crowd, found the best DJs, and made kids from all over the area beg for invites. Going to a Star party was like going to an exclusive club. If you didn't have the right look or know the right people, you couldn't get through the door. And the party she threw for Kelly's last night home had topped them all. Normally, Sheila would never have made the invite list, and she wouldn't have cared a bit. But Kelly had insisted that Star include her, and had begged Sheila to come along. Sheila would, after all, be Kelly's only tie to home once they got to Italy. It was key that the girls get along this summer. Kelly had known Sheila Ramaswamy forever. Their dads had roomed together in college, and their families still got together every so often on weekends. Even though their crowds didn't mix much in school, the girls had a history that kept them together. Sheila and Kelly had been inseparable in elementary school, but things changed in junior high. Kelly got braces, made it onto the dance team, and landed a plum role in the school play. All of a sudden, she was surrounded by a tight new circle of friends and had more and more excuses for spending less and less time with Sheila. By the time they started high school, Sheila was every parent's dream and every party girl's nightmare. She was responsible and mature, got fantastic grades, and stayed out of trouble. Instead of enjoying being 16 and single with a spanking new driver's license, Sheila was wasting the best years of her life on moldy books and the math team. If Kelly could convince her to loosen up and have some fun, maybe there was hope that they'd have a blast together in Italy. When the two girls walked into the party, Star and Tiff hugged Kelly as if it had been months, not hours, since they'd seen her.
"Our guests of honor have arrived," Star announced, ushering them in the door. "So, Kel, are you ready for Bella Roma?"
"The question is Roma ready for us?" Kelly laughed.
"Love your hair, Sheila," Tiff said, smiling at her.
Sheila's hand flew up to her head self-consciously.
"Thanks. Kelly did it for me. And my makeup."
"Well, no wonder it looks fabulous," Star said over her shoulder, as she and Tiff ran off to greet some new arrivals.
"Since when do your buddies even know I exist, much less shower me with compliments?"
Sheila whispered to Kelly.
"Since I told them that you have a pierced nipple and your boyfriend's name tattooed on your butt, and that's why you're so shy about taking your clothes off in gym."
Sheila burst out laughing at the utter ridiculousness of this scenario.
"He must be quite a guy if I'm branding his name onto my ass. Is he cute, at least?"
"Beautiful. He's a Portuguese bad boy with long black hair."
She gave Sheila's dark locks a flip.
"And a Harley. Too bad you're gonna ditch him for a Roman hottie on a Vespa."
The way Kelly said it, it had almost seemed possible. They made their way to the bar, where Kelly, ignoring Sheila's anxious expression, poured them each a glass of punch. Kelly's father was a corporate attorney, and he had developed a technique for making sure his daughter behaved herself at parties. Before going out, she had to sign a contract banning drugs and drinking. It was an effective approach, mostly, but Kelly had become expert at tweaking the rules here and there.
"This is spiked," Sheila said. "Didn't you promise your parents you wouldn't drink tonight?"
"Relax," Kelly answered. "I have a system. Take a few sips, then hold the glass all night. That way, nobody bugs you." Kelly waved at someone on the other side of the room.
"Come on, there's someone I want you to meet."
"Freddie, Sheila, Sheila, Freddie." Kelly put a death grip on Sheila's arm so she wouldn't run away and whispered in her ear.
"One gorgeous Portuguese biker boy with my compliments."
She smiled into her friend's scarlet face. Kelly watched as Sheila cast a furtive glance at Freddy. He smiled and reached out to shake her hand.
"According to Kelly, we've been dating for years. Why don't you tell me about yourself?"
Kelly let the two of them talk while she perched on the arm of a nearby couch and flirted with a few football players from school. One of them held up a lit joint.
"Kel, you want a hit?"
Kelly wrinkled her nose.
"Nope, not my thing. Actually, all the smoke in here is making my allergies go crazy. What I need to do is dance."
She grabbed a partner off the couch and waved to Sheila.
"Have fun, you crazy kids."
She spun on her stilettos and took off. Kelly sighed happily at the memory.
The party had been a total success. Even though Sheila had left early to finish packing, it was obvious that she had enjoyed herself. Kelly hadn't seen her laugh so much since they were little, and she'd never seen her dance before, much less with a guy. Kelly's biggest gamble, enlisting Freddie, a pal from work, to play Sheila's boyfriend, had worked like a charm. It was an absolutely perfect send-off, until the very end of the evening when Tiff had burst into tears. "Summer won't be the same without you. Who will I go to the beach with? The parties are totally gonna suck," she snuffled pathetically. "I'll miss you." "Yeah, and who will I go shopping with?" Star demanded. "I mean, Tiff's okay with shoes, but she can't accessorize to save her life." Kelly put her arm around Tiff. "Come on, guys. It's only 3 months. You'll be back in bags and belts in no time." "It's not just 3 months," Tiffany whined. "You'll come back totally changed, and you won't want to have anything to do with us senior year. And then we'll go off to college, and this will all be over." A wave of nostalgia washed over Kelly as she gazed out the plane window. She wished all of her friends could have come to Italy with her. She had no regrets about saying goodbye to life in the dull suburbs, but she would sorely miss her crew. Exploring Rome had to be 1,000 times more fun than hanging out in Chicago, but doing it alone was no good. She was thankful Sheila would be there with her, even if the girl's social skills needed a major boost. Sheila had reverted to her bookworm ways the instant she'd left Star's house. In fact, if she hadn't been turning a page every now and then, Kelly would have checked her pulse. It was a shame, because Sheila could be lots of fun on the rare occasions she let her guard down. She had a dry kind of wit that cracked Kelly up and a simple, direct style that was a nice break from some of the posers at school. Kelly hoped that at some point this summer, she could convince her old friend to enjoy herself a little. Kelly actually considered it her duty to kick up their friendship a notch. After all, if it hadn't been for Sheila, Kelly would never have found out about the SASS program or the Programma Internazionale di Roma. SASS was a study abroad program for American girls that placed them in schools all around the world, and the Programma was Sheila's school of choice. Its director, Dr. Timothy Wainwright, had been Mr. Ramaswamy's advisor in grad school. Dr. Wainwright had sent Mr. R. a copy of the brochure with Sheila in mind. But the moment Kelly had spied Sheila reading it in the high school cafeteria...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.